Okay guys, I'm making this video again. I'm gonna ask for your help. I'm gonna ask for you guys to do some math for me because we've been lied to for over centuries and they've been blatantly lying to us over centuries because the numbers just don't add up. I took some notes for this video because I think it's very important and it's something we've been preaching on for over 15 years now. It's something that I've been getting a lot of shellac on this channel from and it's the world population. I don't believe the world population is what they're telling us, and they have reasons to tell us it's higher than it should be, because the world's population is nowhere near what they're preaching it to be. Why are they lying to us? So let's look at this, and I got some proof for you guys on this video, okay? This book was published in 1731 in Latin, and this was in the mid-1800s. I got probably over 94 history books that were published pre-World War I, and it's very important that you guys listen to what I found here, and I've been finding these things and scraping them together for you guys over the years, and nobody cares. Why? So this Latin book in 1731 doesn't refer to China as China. It actually calls it the Qing Dynasty or the High Qing Dynasty of Yongzheng, and it was the emperor of 1722 to present. 1722 to present, okay? So when this book was published, he was still, Yongzheng was the emperor of the Qing dynasty. So this emperor implemented strong centralized rule, collected a tax base, and then there was household registration, and they used population figures to calculate grain taxes. And in this book, they state that the Qing, what is China today, is 7.9 million population, and that includes the Middle Kingdom, according to what this book is telling me. The Middle Kingdom and the Qing dynasty, which is China today, has 7.9 million people in 1731. Take note, okay? Now let's go to another history book I have that was published in 1902. Now, this is a very interesting history book because it goes into the China when it came out of a Boxer Rebellion. I have no idea what that is. They went through the invasion by the Eight Nation Alliance. I don't know what that is. And severe famine, war, and deaths, and displacement of people, and massive indemnity payments imposed on China, which I don't know anything about. And they were recording it, leaving it with a population of 53 million people in 1902. According to that book published in 1902, it was stating that China's population was 53 million people. Now, none of this makes any sense because 53 million people in 1902 with famine, wars, and this is before World War I, and then you have World War II, and then you have the Reagan one-child policy. Why were they framing China to have such a massive population? Was it made to fear the rest? Was it made to fear, were they making this up to create this dominance? And we've been asking these questions for years because there's no way that China's population is over 400 million people. There's no mathematical way. So take these numbers, guys. 53 million, 1902. 53 million, 1902. How many kids do they have to be over a billion now in 2025? It doesn't end after all the wars, famine, and all the stuff they were doing. It just didn't. This is before World War I, so I want to know this because I don't believe there's over 400 million people in China and half the population is over 65, in my opinion. 200 million are over 65. And China is crumbling right now and it's getting worse and it's going to get a lot worse. And the population is a myth. It's a lie. And our video series, our 2013 and 14 video series, we did four-part series, Population Myth, where we even counted the populations on, I think it was Wikipedia, and it still never added up. And that series was taken down for bullying back in 2015 or 2016. Somebody reported it for bullying. I'm just asking some basic questions, guys. Now, we're looking at China now, the most populated country in the world. It's just not adding up, folks. It doesn't add up. Let me know what you guys think. Do some math for me on this one, guys. Am I losing my mind, or why doesn't this look right? Are these history books published several hundred years ago lying to me? Are they lying? And if they are, why were they lying in 1731? Why would they lie then? But then the population in 1731 was 7.9 million. Were they over-evaluating those numbers then? How did they reach 7.9 million people in 1731? Let me know in the... Because this is important, guys. Because they're lying about everything. And this is very important. They want us to feel like useless eaters. Let me know what you guys think in the comments. Look forward to looking at some mathematical equations you guys have to make sense of this. Mike Martin's here. I have spoken.